Our second scripture reading this morning is taken from the New Testament book, the book of Revelation. And this is from chapter 21, and I'll be reading the first six verses. Hear now the word of God. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them as their God. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life." And this ends the reading of Scripture. May God bless us with understanding upon hearing God's word. Amen. Back when I was a teenager, I had a friend who has lived with his parents, and they owned 40 acres of ground. And on these 40 acres, they had a 3-acre lake and a boat, and it was stocked with fish. And they had trails that went throughout the 40 acres, and they had dirt bikes. Needless to say, this became my best friend back then. But one time we were actually talking, for some reason, about heaven and what might heaven be like. And my friend, and I'm thinking to myself, the old visions, you know, the streets of gold and blah, blah, blah. And he said, "Heaven has got to be like riding dirt bikes all day long through the trails." And I thought, that's probably a better vision than mine. Back in June of 1917, there was a poem that was written by an anonymous author that appeared in what is called the Hobo News in St. Louis. They actually had a newspaper called Hobo News back then. And the name of the poem was "The Hobo's Last Lament." And what it does is it relates the last words of one of what they used to call the princes of the open road. The last words as he was dying, stretched out of an inside of an empty boxcar on a railroad siding. And this fellow hobo is solemnly listening into this hobo who is dying. And he hears his friend echo these words: "I'm going to a better land where everything is bright, where beef stews grow on bushes, and you sleep out every night. And you do not have to work at all, and never change your socks. And streams of godly, goodly whiskey come trickling down the rocks." To that particular hobo's view and his vision of heaven, it was a little different than dirt bikes, and it was certainly different than streets of gold. And yet the question, what is heaven like, has probably been one that most of us have asked, at least on occasion. Heaven, is it, as the fictional hobo imagined, a place of never-ending campouts and plentiful beef stew and open fountains of whiskey? Is it a dirt bike going through the woods on trails? Or does it more closely conform to the vision of John in the book of Revelation? See, if we were to actually read on in the chapter that I just began reading, in chapter 21, just beyond that particular lesson for today, John actually describes heaven. And he describes heaven this way. He said, "The angel who talked to me had a measuring rod of gold to measure the city and its gates and wall. And the city lies four square, its length the same as its width. And he measured the city with his rod, 1,500 miles. Its length and width and height are equal." John goes on to describe it. "He also measured its wall, 144 cubits by human measurement, which the angels was using. The wall is built of jasper, while the city is pure gold, clear as glass." He writes, "The foundations of the wall of the city are adorned with every jewel, and the 12 gates are 12 pearls. Each of the gates is a single pearl, and the street of the city is pure gold, transparent as glass." Boy, as a teenager, I think the trail, you know, the dirt bike sounded better. You've heard the word, and probably heard the pearly gates. That's where you get it. This scripture, right here. That's the source of that image of pearly gates. You've heard of streets of gold, which was in my mind. That's also where you find that one, right here. But you know, this gold is even different than the gold that we think of. I usually think of gold as the color of a ring or the big bar of gold, but not this gold. No, this gold is what? It is as clear as glass. That's different. That's very different. And yet, as we read this in Revelation 21, this is not about some distant heaven that's far away. John's triumphant vision of heaven is of heaven come to earth. What does he say? The city, it's a new heaven, a new earth, and the city comes down out of heaven from God to earth. Heaven on earth. There's a phrase we have also heard or used. Heaven on earth, it is the stuff that dreams are made of. Heaven on earth, it's our imaginations running wild and rampant. Heaven on earth is our most persistent spiritual yearnings. And oftentimes when people use that phrase, heaven on earth, what they are calling to mind are the most perfect of earthly realities that they can imagine. It's not streets of gold. It's a vista of a dazzling natural splendor, like a waterfall, the mist coming off of a waterfall in a national park. Or maybe for somebody else, it's a cottage by the sea on a perfect temperature midsummer day. Maybe it's that fleeting vision of a rainbow that arcs across the sky that says the storm is over and something new begins. Maybe it's that perfect relationship. Something that causes us to say, this is like heaven on earth. When we imagine heaven come to earth, it sometimes ends up looking like a dirt bike through the woods. It's often not that heavenly vision at all. Rather, it is oftentimes an earthly vision of exquisite perfection. Yet some say that an earthly vision is an impoverished vision. They say that anything earthly could never compete with heaven's glory. They say heaven and earth must be very different. They must be separated. There must be a wall that is between them, kind of like in Jesus' rather grim parable that we may remember. You know, when you have the poor man Lazarus and that contemptuous rich man who shunned him in his life, they both died, and of course Lazarus, we know, goes to heaven, goes to paradise, and the contemptuous rich man does not. And so when this contemptuous rich man just even wants a drink of water, the response of the blessed Lazarus to that rich man, tormented in a fiery, fiery place, is rather bleak, because he says, besides all this, between you and us is a great chasm that has been fixed so that those who might want to pass from here to you cannot do so, and no one can cross from there to us. But there are other images of heaven. Jesus himself talked about the kingdom of heaven being among us, here, part of us. Kind of like the heaven in the hymn, Christ is Alive. One verse says this, it's an Easter hymn, and it says, Brian Wren wrote this, it says, not throned above, remotely high, untouched, unmooned, unmoved by human pains, but daily, in the midst of life, our Savior with the Father reigns, in the here and in the now. For you see, what that hymn begins to speak about is the heavenly blessing of catching a glimpse of heaven on earth. And that glimpse of heaven on earth is when two people who have been apart become reconciled. You get a glimpse of heaven. Forgiveness, unexpected, gives us a glimpse of heaven. Justice for those who have to sit on the outside, that comes to them a glimpse of heaven. Love for each other. Peace on earth and goodwill to all. Those are moments that we get a glimpse of heaven. And when we do, our lives will never be the same again. That's what that hymn speaks to, catching the glimpse of heaven. That's what Jesus spoke to when he talked about kingdom of heaven among you. Now that hobo might hear the whistle of the Glory Land Express, and he might dream of beef stew, and he might dream of whiskey. My friend may dream of dirt bikes through the woods. I may dream of the Cardinals winning every World Series. That's a dream. For some, a nightmare, right? And we too may carry our hopes. We too may carry our dreams. We too may carry our longings for a world that is quite unlike the one that we inhabit. Quite unlike the world that we read about and that we see on the news every day. Quite unlike that. We may dream of a different world. Well, here's the good news. The good news is that even when the smallest of seeds of hope, of reconciliation, of peace, of justice, of love, when just the smallest of seeds falls from heaven to earth, we know that from its very presence, that the transformation of this earth, heaven on earth, has already begun. And we are invited to be a part of it every day. All glory be to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.